Eastern Security Network commander was killed in presence of wife and kids. So must be revenged. Anayochukwu declared. It is a very bad killing. It's a very bad killing, and a very bad one at that. You see, there is nothing that can be thought to be a bad omen and a bad experience to see that your loved ones or the ones that you love so much dearly have been eliminated or killed in your presence. I'm telling you that that kind of thing is a very serious indelible mark. It's like a caption, a very serious caption, a big wound that cannot be able to heal so fast. Look at the kind of killing that is carried out on this young man. And you are telling me that the Nigerian army will find peace, or the Nigerian police will find peace. They will never find peace. Oh, they will never find peace. If the young man's family did not fight, God will fight for them. God is already fighting for IPOP. God is already fighting for IPOP. Can't you see that? God is already fighting. If God is not fighting, this wouldn't have been happening. Look at it now. Since the death of the IPOP commander, negative things begin to happen in Nigeria. Negative things. Abi, is it Kafarati? He's dead. Kafarati is dead. That is the man who prescribed, who announced the prescription of IPOP. He's late. Is it not so? Uh-huh. So that is how every one of them will be passing out one after the other unknowingly to them. They have just embarked on a journey of no return. On a journey of no return, you killed a man in the presence of his family, and you think that you have peace. You think that you have peace. You don't know that God Almighty is very much alive. He's very much alive. It is evil what the police and the Nigerian army has done to the IPOP is evil, and that is why they are getting their share of cake now. What they are going through is what they are going through right now. Yes. A friend was telling me something yesterday that, look, the death of this army chief is going to dig out a lot of secrets, and is going to bring a lot of changes, most especially in that Aso Rock. He said that in the aspect of presidency, is going to reveal truly who is on that seat of presidency. He said that, look, that man we call the president may not be the president. Let me pause there. Let's proceed. Against report from the Imo State Joint Task Force that one of the leader of the Eastern Security Network (ESN), Mr. Anayochukwu Nwakike, aka Ikonso, was killed during exchange of gunfire between the outfit and security operatives elder brother to Ikonso, Mr. Anulike Nwakike, has contended that his younger brother was killed in his house in the presence of his wife and three little children. The elder brother, who spoke to his reporter in Oka, recalled that Ikonso had come home to pass the night, and about 1:45 a.m., the joint task force made up of soldiers and policemen stormed their compound, brought him out and shot him several times until he died. My brother came home to rest and pass the night on that fateful day, but at around 1:45 a.m., we heard noise of heavily armed security men, and they surrounded our compound, broke into the main gate, and started shooting into the air. They went from the house to house, room to rooms, and found him in his room, brought him out, and started firing at him until he died. And in the presence of his wife and three little children, Anulika said, he stated that the five buildings in their compound were attacked, and two were burnt and property destroyed on the onslaught. He added, what the joint task force told you is not true, because I was there when it all happened, and they did not want to talk to anyone and didn't want to listen to anyone. Mukike said that the family of the late Ikonso was going to court to challenge the killing, because they neither took him to court nor arrested him. Also speaking, a UK-based human rights lawyer, Mr. Paul Achala, told reporters that they are going to establish that Ikonso was unlawfully killed, contrary to the African Charter on Human and People's Rights and that of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. This was exactly what happened during the Apo killing of some evil persons in Abuja by police officers, and it all went that way, but this time it will not work because this is extrajudicial killing. The killing is contrary to what the police said about his death, and we shall pursue it legally, and we are demanding that his corpse be given a befitting burial. Achala said Ikonso, 39, was said to be a youth leader at his own town, Awamama, Oro West, in Imo State, and led the resistance against the presence of Fulani herdsmen on the farm before joining the Eastern Security Network. His wife could not speak with reporters due to her psychological state occasioned by the killing of her husband. It is a wicked killing, and very, very wicked. That is why they all will keep dying one after the other. Alright, let me hear from you from the outside, my dear viewers. Don't forget to leave your comments below the comment box. Click on the subscription buttons as well as bell buttons to get updated each time we upload any new videos. Thank you.